Hey, welcome back. My name is Pastor Chris. I'm the Associate Pastor of Christian Growth right here at Trinity in Utica. And you are in session two of the study, I Am With You. I Am With You, those are words that Jesus spoke to his disciples. And in many ways, perhaps with those specific words and in many other ways, God speaks those to his people throughout time. And so this whole session, this whole study is about learning how to share our faith. Because God is with you, number one, that means you have a story to share. And number two, that means that when you think about sharing your faith, sometimes you can get freaked out. It can be a little intimidating, or you can feel a lot of anxiety about it. And so this study is designed to lower that anxiety, raise your confidence, and remind you of that truth that God is giving you, that you do have a story to share. And so Pastor Justin is here with us today again to help us answer this question this week, which is, what story do we share? If we have a story, what story do we share?
Okay. Yeah. What story do we share? Just the big picture, right? The story that God is with us. God is with us. That's a story that we share. And I love what we're doing here. Peter says, always be prepared to give an answer for the hope that you have. And so be prepared. Right, Pastor Chris and I, we're hoping to prepare you so that in the moment, right, you're ready, that you've thought through it. And so what story do you share in that moment? The next couple of weeks, we're really going to get down to the nitty-gritty of that. But really, when it comes to the story that God is with us, last week we talked about Hebrews 11, right? We saw how God was with all those individuals that are mentioned in Hebrews 11. And certainly we have a story, just like all those individuals have a story, because a living God was with them and he's with us. And so this week, really what we want you to do is to start writing down all the significant things that have happened in your life. We want you to prepare your life story, and ultimately it will come down to your faith story. And so a way that I prepared this, actually, when I was 19 years old, what was happening in my life, I just really felt like I need to write this down just to identify what was going on. It was kind of like a journaling process. But I started off from when I was born in my family, wrote about my family, and just wrote all the way to all the significant events that happened until I was 19 years old, 20 years old. And so I don't know how old you are. I don't know everything that's gone in your life, but I think a first step in just preparing to let God just speak to you about how he's been with you is just literally sitting down. If it's a piece of paper, it's like English class 101, how to prepare a speech. You just write down every significant thing that you can think of that took place in your life. Then as you write that down, and I would encourage you, it's always good to do this in community if you have somebody to walk through the story of how God has shaped your life, to say, hey, I want to know more about that part, that part, that part, that part. Or even before that, for you to actually write out your story. It could be 5 pages long, 10 pages long. I don't know how long your story is, but I would just put pen to paper or hands to a keyboard and just start typing out your story. Yeah. Your story, your life story, because when you look at your life story, you see it's actually God's story. And then, right, if you're able to do that, and that's going to take some work, right? This is a Bible study. It's not just about receiving. It's about putting in and digging in, right? That takes work to write out your story. But then if you want to start identifying stories, right, that's when you can circle stuff, or maybe even the outline other people have identified. Hey, I want to know more about that, 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 and that. And what we'll see, and what you'll see, what I saw in my own life, what I see still today, is there is a salvation story. There's a salvation story for each of us. Right, for me, I was born into a Christian family, but then over the last 19 years, God really worked it out to where when I was 19, I finally said, yes, I am saved. Yes, I believe. For many of us, it was just one specific moment, but for me, it was a 19-year-long process for me to really understand that salvation story. So when I share my salvation story, it's 19 years of God doing stuff in my life and about five or six really significant things that have happened. Growth stories, right? So there's a difference between salvation stories. Right, growth stories, big terms that we use as pastors would be just justification story and the sanctification stories. Right, we believe that we're being sanctified, that God is continually forming us into the person of his son Jesus. And when we write out our life stories, right, we see all these significant things. Perhaps they're trials, perhaps they're not trials, they're good moments, but these big moments, right, where we see that God ultimately has refined our faith. Mm-hmm. And the power of this story is that it's so relatable. Our stories are so relatable because we're taking truths that we know are true from the scriptures, but we're making it real in our lives. And God's done that already. It's just a matter of us preparing and identifying that. And so for the next 3 weeks, we are inviting you into truly an equipping class, if you will, to where you're going to have to do a lot of work. You're going to have to do a lot of work, but God's already done that work. But if you want to be prepared, and we want you to be prepared, we want to equip you. And so today you're really beginning just the journey of writing out your whole life story. And then next week we'll start identifying actually stories in your life and encouraging you to do that. And then we'll ultimately hopefully line up scripture verses that line up with these sanctification stories that you have. So I think that might answer your question that you asked me. How do we identify our story? Well, we got to write out our story first.
Yeah.
We got to really just think through our story. We actually do this with eighth graders, right? We just went through confirmation interviews, right? Andrew Brazil, our youth minister, had the kids do their faith stories, and he asked for five different moments in their life, right? They're only 13, 14 years old, but they all did it. And so that's what we're asking you to do, right? Do the same thing these eighth graders did. And what they did is they processed their life, right? They identified key moments, they wrote about those key moments, and then ultimately they applied God's word to those key moments. And so there's a testimony that they know that has encouraged their own faith, strengthened their own faith, and now they are prepared to answer anybody that would ask about the hope that they have.
Yeah, that's good. That's good stuff, brother. When you're talking about just writing out your life story, sometimes, I mean, maybe it's a sentence, and maybe you just start with, I don't know what to write. And so you can just start with honesty with yourself and go from there and remember a scene from when you were younger, or if you are younger, a scene from earlier in your life. And I just go one scene at a time and see how God unfolds your story for you as you begin to explore and write that out. And maybe you're a little more prolific, right? You're a little more gifted with your memory and the things that stick out in your mind, and you can write it out on paper, type it out on a screen, however that looks, and you can go pages and pages. Do the process, just like Pastor Justin, you were saying, do that work. Because as you do the effort of remembering, recalling, writing, God's going to bless that. God's going to be a part of that, and he's going to show you maybe things you've forgotten, or he's going to reinforce those things that are true for you and what he's done in your life and how he's spelled that out for all of us through his word. And as you do that, we'll be here with that next step coming to you next week. And there'll be a few steps after that, but you're at the next step in the process, so get ready. If you haven't already, if you find this study helpful, click subscribe and hit the bell so you get updated. Click like on the video if this is a good video for you, and find a way to share it with other people who might also find it useful. Any interaction, any ways you pass this on sure means a lot to us. And the work God is calling us to do. And we're so grateful that you are part of it. Pastor Justin, man, thanks for leading us through this next question and what to do with it. Click the link below now to continue on in the next session two for this, the worksheet we've prepared for you. And that'll take you through the rest of this, the process for this session. Thanks again for joining us. We'll see you next week. God bless you.